World in figure skating, a world where lines have been crossed and new paths explored, a world of professionals and amateurs together colliding and competing on ice. With this new world, a new format, new rules, regulations, restrictions. Today in Kitchener, Canada's pairs champions, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz, will challenge their old foes. World champions turned pros, Mandy Wutzel and Ingo Stoya. In dance, Evgeny said, goodbye Pasha, hello Maya. And now this new partnership, Usova and Platov, will go head-to-head with Canadian champions, but pro-am rookies, Shaylin Bourne and Victor Kratz. The men are ready. Jeff Langdon will skate against his heroes, like Brian Orser, who can still spin and fly with the best, and Captain Canada, Kurt Browning, who is back in the heat of battle. Don't go away. Two big shows ahead. CTV Sports, Canada's Figure Skating Network, brings you inside the Memorial Auditorium Complex in Kitchener, Ontario, one of the great hotbeds for figure skating in Canada. For the 1998 Sears Figure Skating Open, and earlier today, recognize the music in the background? Riverdance. You'll hear it later tonight. That's Bourne and Kratz working on their interpretive free dance. And some skaters who won medals on a world stage years ago, competing against guys who are doing that today. We're getting set for a very interesting day here in Kitchener. Hi, everybody. I'm Rod Black. Welcome to the fifth Canadian Professional Championship, but I don't have to tell you that this one is much different. This is an open event, which means Olympic-eligible skaters against skaters who are not. In the old days, you used to have pros, you used to have amateurs, but now the International Skating Union has come in and brought both worlds together with rules. The pros never used to have rules. They are International Skating Union rules. A short program, and then later tonight, you will have the interpretive free skate. ISU judges in a marking system, which means it's out of 6.0. The free skate and free dance will go later. Original dance is worth 50%. Interpretive dance also worth 50%. And again, as I mentioned, you have eligible and ineligible pros and amateurs together. Big money, of course, $40,000 to the winners today. Second place, $30,000 and down the line. Just a programming note, we will have the men, the women, the pairs, and the dance this afternoon for you, the short programs. Later tonight, we will have the interpretive free skates of all of those except the pairs. Next Saturday on CTV Sportsnet, tune in for the pairs competition. We will highlight that specifically. Lots going on in the world of skating. The NHK Trophy, the Grand Prix Series, no pros involved in that. Good news for Canada. Jamie Soleil and David Pelche have won a bronze medal at the NHK Trophy. We will highlight and update more from NHK throughout the day. Elvis Stoiko is here. He won't be skating. He is in the building, however. He will be watching. What a week it's been for Elvis. He re-aggravated his groin injury in Hamilton last week, had to pull out of his show. He was back on ice practicing this week. He says he's okay, and Debbie Wilkes will talk to him. Debbie Wilkes will also be speaking with one of our competitors today, Brian Orser. He's been in the news lately. A much publicized palimony suit for Mr. Orser, and one of Canada's greatest skaters later will speak for the very first time about his sexuality and his life away from the ice. So lots ahead. 3 hours of skating and news. And Barb Underhill, you used to compete in these professional competitions when they didn't have rules. This is very different.
It's very, very different. I think that it's great for pro skating, though. Pro skating has grown so much over the past 10 years since we've been involved, but it has had very little structure, and it needs structure to have the credibility. I think this brings credibility to pro skating.
There are some skaters who will have none of this. Brian Boitano, Christy Yamaguchi, yes. Isabel Brasseur, and Lloyd Eisler.
And there are many of the pro skaters that actually hate this format, but I actually think that it favors the pros. When you really look at it, and we'll go into it a little bit later, it does favor the pros. But I think it's also extremely intimidating for them to get back out on the ice in front of ISU judges.
Yeah.
That's why they went pro in the first place, to get away from that, to get away from the seriousness of it all, and to have more fun, to have more freedom, and I think they feel that they're being pulled back again.
Great crowds in here today. We got a sellout, standing room only tonight, but the most interested spectator, folks, will be you, because you did this. You were competing, and it's wide open now.
It is just so different now, and watching the practices yesterday, for the eligible skaters, you're looking at them and they're so relaxed because this is easy for them. When you're looking at the pro skaters, they're so tense because this is, you know, this is so much more serious than what they're used to.
Well, as I said, 3 hours ahead this afternoon, 2 hours tonight on CTV and CTV Sportsnet. And with us for the duration, as always, our reporter backstage, let's join Rob Faltz.
Well, Rod and Barb, you mentioned that some of the pros not very happy about this ISU-sanctioned event where they have to go have required elements. One of the most outspoken on this, having to go back in front of the judges, is Kurt Browning.
I'm a professional, and my job is to entertain. And in 2 minutes 40 seconds with 8 elements, I don't have any time to do any of that. I think that it's a whole afternoon of watching people trying to fit 8 elements into 2 minutes 40 seconds or 2 minutes 30 seconds, and I find that not very appealing, both for television and for audience. So if I was to change this for next year, I would say, go ahead, keep the short program, keep the deductions, keep the 8 elements, just give us a little more time to do it so that we can maybe have a little moment somewhere in there to do something of interest instead of just scrambling to my next element. I'm exhausted in 2 minutes. And, you know, I think that that's going to be the hardest thing. If I can get through the short program, I'll be okay. I'm very nervous about it.
As the women get ready to take to the ice, there is a noticeable omission. Karen Kadavy of the United States has withdrawn from the competition because of an injured back. And also suspect but ready to be here to compete is Canada's Liz Manley. She is suffering from a bout of the flu. We spoke to Liz about exactly how serious her illness is.
I saw the doctors this morning. I have 2 ear infections, so they drained out my canals about 2 hours ago. And starting a little bit of bronchitis, so I'm a little not really here. I feel like I'm an episode of X-Files right now. I'm just a little weary, and I've already actually been asked if I want to pull out, but I'm a fighter. I'll go out there, and I don't have high expectations of myself because of how I'm feeling at this point. And, you know, I'm just in a sweat and just not quite myself, not quite the Liz that people are used to seeing.
Liz told me the most difficult thing is because the spins are required to have 8 revolutions. When she's in her layback spin, and the problem with her balance, as she says, when she comes out of the spin, she's almost too wobbly to continue. She said it'll be interesting to see how it all turns out here in Kitchener. Rod?
There's José Chouinard. A marathon day of skating ahead on CTV. Stay with us, everybody. We get it started next. Liz Manley getting ready to warm up. Canada's sweetheart, 10 years ago. Time flies when you're having fun. Beside her is Tanya Kwiatkowski. 5 women in the field. José Chouinard, Karen Preston, and also Nicole Bobek. As Rob Faltz mentioned, Karen Kadavy has pulled out. We'll have the women, the pairs, the dance, and the men. So we've got a jam-packed afternoon, and we have required elements.
Yes, we do. And looking at the women in the field on practice yesterday, José Chouinard has never looked better. She's been working with Doug Lee, and there is something very different about her. She is so confident. Her jumps are consistent. Hopefully she can hang on to that out here today. But she hasn't done a short program. We have to remember she has not done a short program since 1994 in front of ISU judges, where you have to actually count the revolutions in the spin and really pay so much attention to detail of each of the individual elements. But I think also her main competition here is Nicole Bobek, who is on a mission. She is on a comeback trail, still having a little bit of difficulty with some of the consistency of her jumps, but certainly she is one to watch for.
Back to José for just a minute. I was watching practice yesterday. There are very few women, and have been very few women in the world, who are able to land a triple axel. I don't think she ever did it in competition. She was landing them in practice, and maybe that's because she's at that jumping factory now at Mariposa with Doug Lee.
Absolutely, and we spoke to Doug yesterday about it. He said she could do the jumps. She just needed to do them consistently, to have that technique be the same every time she entered the jump.
Let's talk about Liz Manley now. Rob alluded to the fact that she's got some problems with an inner ear affliction right now, and that's got to affect her. She's still one of the great sprites on the ice, and she's full of energy, but that may sap her, and it may take away one of her advantages.
Well, you have to think that that would really affect her balance, and particularly in the short program where they are required to do so many spins. They are required to do 3 spins, and they all have to have a certain number of revolutions, and I think that really could affect her.
The women first. They're warming up. We'll have that women's short program from the 98 Sears Figure Skating Open next on CTV. The Sears Figure Skating Open. José Chouinard, one of the most famous skaters in the women's field in Canada for sure. And let's join Rob Falls backstage with an interested spectator today.
You know, there are lots of nerves before you compete, but maybe the most nervous guy here might be this man, Jean-Michel Bombardier, husband of José Chouinard. It's a different kind of nerves, though, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. But she's ready. She's looking good. She had great practice, and actually, I enjoy being on this side of the boards now.
Now, let me ask you, what are you doing right now that you've sort of stepped away from the ice?
I'm in school full-time at George Brown College doing marketing. I really enjoy it, and I've been coaching a bit in Barrie and in Thornhill.
All right, I'll let your nerves just get the better of you. Jean-Michel Bombardier.
Here are the required elements for the women's short program. They must do a double axel, a double or a triple jump, and it has to be straight out of footwork, one jump combination, a flying spin, a layback spin, a spin combination, a spiral step sequence, and a step sequence. And this all must happen within 2 minutes and 40 seconds.
José Chouinard will skate first, the 3-time Canadian champion who has won as a professional as well. She did try to come back as an eligible skater in 1996, finished second at the national championships.
But you know, Rod, watching her yesterday on practice, she could walk into the world championships now and at least medal, if not win. She is that good. We just hope that she can hold it together here today. Unfortunately, she has drawn the number one skating position.
There's Doug Lee. A lot of famous pupils from around the world.
Well, you can do this right now. It's very simple. You can do this right now. Exactly. Feel the edges, feel grounded. All right? Let it breathe.
So anybody who thinks a professional doesn't need those words, it's still a competition. And we get it started.
She has 2 new programs this year, choreographed by Lori Nickel. And this is Embraceable You. Thank you. Very nice.
She won her first national championship almost 9 years ago. She's 29 now.
Her personality just shines in that program. And although she had a couple of missteps on the jump, she just has an aura of confidence that you just see, and it shines through throughout the program. But unfortunately, she will have some deductions on those two elements. Here's a look at the triple lutz combination. She just can't check that first jump out, has a little rotation in between, and just hangs on to that second jump. Here's the double axel. And you, as you mentioned, Rod, earlier, she is landing a triple axel. Now watch on the toe pick on the takeoff here. She doesn't get it in properly. She doesn't get the lift off that she needed.
Yeah, we're just right there for the taking. Straight, you're over your feet.
Yeah.
And that effervescent smile that has lit up arenas all around the world.
So much better than the beginning of the practice. The warm-up, I mean. As I was skating, felt the ice
match. And the ISU judges. I wonder if Jose had any inkling when she turned professional that she would see these people ever again and would have to do triple jumps ever again. But I think, and I think a lot of people feel, this is the way that skating is going in the future.
Well, as I mentioned before, pro skating needed structure. It needed something because there were so many events out there, you didn't really know what each meant. They really didn't have any meaning, so they're really attempting to draw this in and draw it under the ISU umbrella and make it more meaningful.
It really works for someone like Jose, though, who is just out of amateur skating, just out of the competitive
horse. She can still do all the elements.
For someone like Karen Kadavy, who's not skating today, but someone like Elizabeth Manley, who has been such a pro skater, hasn't had to do triple jumps, it must be very difficult.
Very difficult.
Then you think about someone like Ryan Orser, who we'll see later today, and I talked to him yesterday. I expected him to say, I hate this.
He loves it.
He loves it.
4.9, 5.1, 4.8.
And again, look at the required elements marks. Jose Chouinard is a professional, hasn't had marks like that from pro judges.
But wait till you see the presentation marks. They will go way up, and they do.
And she obviously is the number one skater right now. And those are the marks. The rest of the field, the remaining four skaters will have to beat. Her interpretive free skate comes tonight and advantage Jose.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Canada, Karen Preston.
Wasn't too long ago we were doing national championships and Jose Chouinard and Karen Preston were battling neck and neck. This is a two-time national champion of Canada.
She's been out of amateur skating for the longest, having won her national titles in 89 and 91. So this has got to be very tough for her coming back to this format again. Thank you. pulls it off. And here's her combination spin, which must have 6 revolutions on each foot.
Been away from amateur skating for a while, but she looks like she never left.
That is great.
Shades of 1992 in Moncton, when she won her second national title, went on to finish 8th at the Albertville Winter Olympics. Welcome back, Karen Preston.
So close. Fast. The rhythm.
So excited about laying this one down. Watch this opening combination. Triple flip. Let's watch to see if there's a 2 foot there, and there is. There's a small deduction for that 2 foot there. But I don't think she cares about that right now. And here's the triple toe loop. This was very clean. And the double axel was a little bit wild. A little bit on a lean there, but she squeaked it out.
You love pictures like this. She has, in the last few years, been cast as Snow White in innumerable productions.
She's been touring constantly with Disney.
Her required,
the crowd is booing here.
Required elements marks are better than Jose's. I think it will take a while for even the crowd to realize that these are International Skating Union judges, and they're harsh. Karen Preston moves ahead of Jose Chouinard, and she is first.
5.3, 5.3, 5.4. Ladies and gentlemen, from the United States, Tanya Kwiatkowski.
Recently left the eligible ranks and now skates as a professional. Tanya Kwiatkowski, one of the lasting images from Minneapolis, her last world championship, the performance of her life, and all she said at the end of it was, wow.
And she finished 6th at that world championships, and she just finished touring across Canada with Elvis Stoiko. Steps into the triple toe loop jump. Very nice.
Tanya Kwiatkowski of the United States. She was a veteran as an amateur skater at the Worlds. Now she's a rookie as a pro.
Great performance for a rookie.
Liz Manley, still to skate at the 98 Sears Figure Skating Open.
If you could capture
only by myself, it's weird. One of the things about being a pro, your coach generally doesn't come with you.
Very often you don't bring a coach. This was a flawless combination here. Very clean landing there, straight up into the double toe loop. And that element has a higher rating of difficulty than the triple flip, which Karen Preston performed. And this was her combination spin. As I mentioned, the judges are counting the revolutions, which I'm sure she fulfilled 6 on each foot. And at the very end of the program, just barely hangs on to that double axel. Very often the skaters place the double axel at the very end of the program. And when they're skating cleanly, they're going into it going, I can't mess up now, I can't mess up now. That happens so often.
Required elements marks, the best of the bunch so far from the ISU judges. And again, it's an international skating panel.
5.4.
Presentation marks, pretty good. And Tanya Kwiatkowski has moved in front, and so far a pattern developing. The skaters that have had amateur status recently are doing better than the skaters who retired a couple of years ago. And here's someone who should really benefit from these rules in the short program. Nicole Bobek just finished second at the Trophée Lalique. We'll have that for you on CTV Sportsnet next week. So she's also been competing in professional competitions.
She is so determined this year to come back from her disastrous finish at the Olympic Games where she was 17th. She's back with her old coach, Richard Callahan, the coach of Tara Lipinski. And she'll be opening here with a triple Lutz combination. She does it! Look at that flying camel spin. Gorgeous. Looking extremely focused out here. She needs to keep that focus going into this double axel.
The best we have seen her skate in a long time. She knows it. Nicole Bobeck, she'll be our leader when we come back to Kitchener after this break.
What a performance.
And she is serious this year. Watch this combination. She goes over on the inside edge here.
I felt like it wasn't good, and I was like, ugh.
No, nice height.
All I thought was right shoulder.
Well.
And I was like, oh my God, I'm close to the boards. I got scared. Was the spins long enough?
The spins were awesome.
Yes, they were. You made the last one just long enough. Because, you know, you
many of the elements, including the spiral sequence, were just a level above the other skaters. Here's the double axel.
Made that.
Ooh. I didn't touch that.
Youngest skater in the field.
I didn't think you did.
No, I didn't.
Certainly the most competitive ready. Game face on because she's competing throughout the season as well.
5.6.
Interesting at the U.S. National Championships. Look at the 5-1 there and 5-2. That's interesting. But at the U.S. National Championships, Michelle Kwan says she's coming back. Michelle Kwan may have just been sent a message from Nicole Bobeck.
Well, Nicole is so determined to get back that national championship, which she won in 1995, and regain that form that she had back then when she was with Richard Callahan.
First across the board, Nicole Bobeck.
My footwork started laughing.
Again, Karen Kadavy was supposed to skate here.
Elizabeth Manley.
She has pulled out, but our last skater, 10 years ago, won the silver medal, the Winter Olympics in Calgary. Still skating, but today skating with an inner ear problem. Elizabeth Manley.
This has to be a very tough situation for Liz, not only competing a short program here in front of ISU judges, but definitely not at the top of her game right now. On a severe lean in the air there.
Gotta give her credit though. Not feeling well, and for the first time in 10 years, skating in front of judges who are counting spins and rotations, but she still loves to compete.
Well, you could see that this isn't the Liz we're used to seeing. She just didn't have that spark.
CTV's coverage of the 98 Sears Figure Skating Open will continue.
Not feeling well. She has bronchitis. There's Karen Preston.
They've just finished touring together across the country with Elvis Stoico.
You almost did.
Here's a look at the triple sow cow.
You followed through. It was right there. And that's then just boom. I could have pulled that. You could have pulled that. I had to keep that right side up.
Ready
for it.
I rotated. Here was the double flip.
I had no idea what that was like.
That was good.
Was your okay?
Yeah.
Was the axle okay?
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
I love you, Mom.
She was hacking and still is. And
we
that
already
is
have
so
the same
difficult.
Sickness. It's all right.
When you start sweating out on the ice,
the marks will require elements.
Don't kill me. Oh, my God.
Required elements marks.
What is it?
It reflects, these reflect the fact that she has such a low base mark because of the low difficult, low level of difficulty as well as the mistakes, the deductions for the mistakes.
33-year-old Elizabeth Manley.
5.5.
Fifth position.
5.7. 5.6.
Beside her,
5.5.
Substitute coach Karen Preston. And Preston is third. Chouinard is fourth. Tanya Kwiatkowski second, Nicole Bobek first. Remember, tonight, a little different. The rules are relaxed a little bit with the interpretive free skate, so it could be an advantage for Jose, Liz, and Karen. Nicole Bobek, the leader. Tremendous performance this afternoon in Kitchener. Let's join Rob Falls.
Well, the youngest competitor in the women's field is also the leader right now, Nicole Bobek. It looks like these rules might be right up your alley.
Definitely, this gives us a chance, or us amateurs, to give us a chance to really go out there and run through our technical programs.
Well, you got a wow from Barb Underhill. She loved your program. Things really were well put together.
Thank you.
What was the key coming here? Just to get some experience, just to get a chance to sort of maybe cut loose a little bit?
Basically, what goes in through my head during these events is basically just to do another run through, except you got the audience there and you're the only one out there. So it gives you a good chance to get over your nerves, and I feel a lot better about myself out there since the beginning of the season.
You said that you found out you're going to the Grand Prix Final. That's a real bonus. I guess now sights set on U.S. Nationals.
Definitely. It's my goal to win back my title. It's been a goal for a while, so I'm taking it personal this year and really going for it.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
She skates like that. Look out, Michelle Kwan. Chris Wirtz, Victor Kratz. The guy in the Canada sweater is Elvis. We'll talk to him when we come back.
Well, I don't know. That's the way it came off. It's not the way it felt inside, for sure. It was close to 5 years, and it's a little different coming back from the pro ranks, seeing the amateur judges there, and they're all sitting there, and they're all looking over their owl glasses, and, you know, I didn't really like it very much.
Are you one of those skaters that are a little upset about the fact that it's so disciplined in terms of what you have to put in that short program? I know Kurt's not very happy about it because it's jam-packed in a very short time.
It's hard. I mean, particularly for Kurt, myself, and Jose, and even Karen Knavy. Unfortunately, she withdrew. But for those of us that have been in the pro ranks for, you know, 3, 4, 5 years, we're used to entertaining the crowd. And when they say you have to put 8 elements in 2 minutes and 40 seconds, there's no time to interact with the crowd, which is what we've come to enjoy and what we've come to love. So that's the only disappointing part. I think it's good to have rules. Just give us a little bit more time to do it.
Well, let me talk to you about the end of this program. You seem delighted with the way it all shaped up, and your reaction at the end of the program certainly showed that.
Well, I was pretty happy. I didn't find out about coming here until the very final performance of the Elvis Stoico tour that I was on, so I had 5 days' notice. And that program has not been skated, period, in 13 months. So that was like the first run through in 13 months. I'd say that was pretty good.
Well, then, what kind of high do you go in then to the interpretive tonight?
This is where the pros shine. This is the entertaining. And I have a new number that was choreographed by David Wilson that I did on the Elvis tour that shows a completely different side of Karen Preston that people from the amateur times back in the day won't really recognize me. They'll be like, wow, I can't believe she's doing that. So
good luck to you.
Thanks very much.
Karen Preston, the top Canadian right now here at the
Kitchener.